Hi everyone, I'm Cody at W3AMG with Bridgecom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to create your own talk group with your own DMR ID. So if you have your own very own DMR ID, which you should if you're in DMR, you can actually create your own talk group using that ID to allow your buddies or maybe just a couple friends to talk together without interrupting anyone else in their talk group. Alrighty, so first things first, we're going to program up our radio in order to do this. Now, the key is your friends will have to do the same thing. So we've already had them do that. These two radios here, they have different users, and both of these hotspots are set to private, so there's gonna be no interference directly. So we're gonna plug our radio in here. Plug the radio in, make sure it's turned on, just like that. Now on the computer, go ahead and open up your programming software. Now you'll wanna make sure before you do anything, just read from your radio. If you haven't done so already, you should do that before doing anything in the CPS. We've already done that here, so we are okay. And what we are going to do is make a channel here with our own DMR ID. Now to do that, go down to the digital tab and go to contact/talk group. So once we're here, we're going to create a new talk group. If you have a lot, just scroll down to the bottom, create yourself a new one, and give it a name. So we'll name it Cody's Talk Group. You want to make this a group call, obviously, because we're going to be, the idea is we'll talk to multiple people on it. And instead of putting in a talk group number that you're familiar with, such as a, you know, talk group 91, like the worldwide, we're actually going to use our own DMR ID. So in this case, 315-2688, and click OK. And there we go. We have it in the radio. Now go over to your channel and create a new channel here and put in the information for, you know, whatever device you're using it with. In this case, it's a hotspot. So we'll put on our frequency. Digital low power is fine. That's fine. We're going to select the contact. Want to make sure you do that. And we'll select our new talk group that we created. Color code, it can stay as one, time slots. Now, if you already have talk groups for your hotspot or channels, you can probably just duplicate one of them and change the name and the contact. So once we have that done, just go ahead and add that to a zone. So I'm just going to add it to my little zone I have here, just for testing. So we'll go ahead and add that. Click OK. And at this point, you are ready to go. So just go ahead and write that to your radio. So click the Write to Radio button up top. And then click OK. And all you need is the other data for this information. And that's going to write to the radio. Now the key is all of your buddies will have to do the same thing. And what I mean by the same thing is quite literally the same. They don't want to use their ID, they want to use yours. This would work for anyone, but you just have to use one person's ID if you want it to work as a group. So it doesn't matter if you use your ID or one of your buddies. The key is everyone just has to use that same DMR ID if you want it to work like a group. And obviously make sure they check a group call as opposed to private call. There we go. So we can unplug our radio now. And at this point, we have a few different radios here set up with different IDs and call signs. And I'll show you that just so we're on the same page here. So we'll boot up these radios. Make sure you can see that. We'll go to menu, go down to settings and device info. This is the one we just programmed. Got my name and call sign and my radio ID. Now, if we take this radio over here, it's booted up all the way. We'll go down to settings, device info. There we go. Got another call sign and radio ID. Now we'll have a look at this one. Go down to settings, device info. There you go, another radio ID. Now you will have to actually key these radios up if you want it to work properly. So we do have the same talk group programmed in all of them. So let's go ahead and switch to that. There we go, oops, passed it. There it is. Now this radio is already set on it. So we'll go ahead and select that talk group on our radio. There we go, Cody's talk group. Awesome, there we go. So we have everything selected there. Now, to make this work, we will actually need to key up all of the radios. So we'll key these up. There you go. Awesome. And we'll key this one up. And I'm going to talk into this one. This is W3AMG. There we go. It's working. We'll turn the volume up a little bit on the radios. This one was a little bit loud. We'll turn it down. These are completely separate radios with completely different DMR IDs and call signs. And it is working. We're talking to it. How cool is that? W3AMG. Awesome. How cool is that? So it is working. This is an awesome feature if you and your buddies want to just create a private talk room, you know, to talk about whatever without tying up some other talk room.